Classism can be defined as the prejudice against or in favor of people belonging to a particular social class. It was and still is used to suppress the weaker classes in order to give more power to those at a higher class. Depending on someone's economic status, amount of education, family name, and what type of job they have let you know what class they are a part of. The higher class make the most money and is typically a much smaller percentage of the population than the middle and lower class. The lower class, however, make the least money and tends to make up a much larger percentage of the population. During the 1920s, there was a large divide between the social classes that separated the rich from the poor in many aspects. Tom Buchanan and Jay Gatsby are prime examples of the upper class. They were very rich, had big houses on the water, and lived in the wealthiest part of New York. An example of classism here would be when Jay Gatsby tells Nick how he was disappointed that his parents were never inspired to have a better life than the one they did, and Gatsby never forgave them for that. Daisy Buchanan, Jordan Baker, and Nick Carraway were somewhere in between the upper class and middle class, but closer to the upper class. Even though Nick lived next door to Gatsby, he didn't have as much money as him. Daisy got most of her money through Tom, but still came from a successful family. Jordan was a successful golf player, which is how she got most of her money. Myrtle Wilson and her husband, Mr. Wilson, were part of the lower class. Mr. Wilson was the owner of a gas station, which didn't earn him a lot of money. Myrtle doesn't have a job, so the two depended on the money made at Wilson's garage. They weren't always treated as nicely as the other characters, and the author chose to describe Mr. Wilson as being dirty and wearing old, worn clothes to show the difference in class.
The Great Gatsby's main characters are clearly divided among three social classes: the wealthy elite social class, the newly rich social class, and the working class. You can clearly see the way that Fitzgerald portrays class in how people act around the lower class characters in the novel, and the way that Gatsby is treated because of his newly acquired wealth. This helps to add another layer of depth into the story, as we can always see the ways that different characters would act and be treated based on their social classes. Such as an example with Gatsby's lavish parties, people treated him very poorly because his money was new. In the novel, we can see a similarity to the real classes present in the 1920s that we see in the book. This is present in the fact that we have the low class, such as Myrtle and George. But we also have the upper class on the other hand, such as Tom, Daisy, Nick, and Gatsby. At the same time, Nick isn't living a lavish life such as Tom, Daisy, Gatsby, and Jordan. But he was born into money, so he's still a member of the upper class, although he is closer to being in the middle class.
Typically, the lower class consisted of farmers, immigrants, African Americans, and people who worked for more traditional businesses that had been outdated by new technology, such as textile workers and coal miners. Women were also paid very little compared to male counterparts and were often given jobs that involved cooking, cleaning, and fitting the common stereotypes. In the middle class, most of the jobs were known as blue-collar jobs. These jobs were mostly in mechanics, construction, and mining, where they would be paid hourly instead of having a set salary. As for the upper class, they took up a very small percentage of the total people in America. These people were the entertainers, successful businessmen, and some were politicians.